I mean, I had a good raid.
First floor is all boarded up.
Yeah, we faced these guys before.
Man, the first trailers were so cool. Used to be so good.
From the very start, we all knew that Siege would be something different. The showcase of the game's versatile gunfights and environmental destruction completely
set it apart from any other game. Hold on, let me put subtitles on for you guys.
Garnering a lot of attention.
Sorry about that. Rabbit Hole Time, UV logo
after
is a stylized 666.
Feedback about this environmental versatility, another year of development went by.
Wait, what?
Until finally, on the 1st of December 2015, Rainbow Six Siege was released to the world.
That's some conspiracy shit right there, bro. Yo, Reason in the building. Wait, UB logo. What?
Fast forward 2 months, and Ubisoft have now released the very first DLC for Siege, Operation Black Ice, which unveiled two new operators, a new map, and an abundance of new cosmetics, including the Glacier skin, which is still one of the rarest and most sought-after skins. The main reason that the game gained a lot of traction was because of the heavy emphasis on strategy, because after all, this game had revolutionized the SWAT shooter
genre. I was sick, dude.
The dedicated
I had to
developer
use some,
team made plenty of
changes,
such as being unable to hear enemies shouting, changing objective rotations, reinforcements blocking bullets, and many, many more. Operation Black Eye showed the community what was in store for Siege. And the future was looking bright.
So Mudlangi says, I miss the early days of R6 when we're playing like COD. We did not care about picking and bugs. I mean, I think there was a reason why, because it was actually a good game back then, dude. Like genuinely, the first 2 to 3-ish years were so much fun, man. I had so much fun, dude. It was a great game. It just went downhill. I mean, you'll see in this video, right?
With the player base slowly but surely increasing and the variety of gadgets and operators expanding, Siege was evolving into the FPS that everyone was anticipating.
I think the main thing that I take away from the game is simplicity was good.
Well, I was kind of surprised, like, how much it's going to break the metagame, actually. And that's the case, like, that's really what Ubisoft wants, right? But you guys are going to see, you're going to be really surprised at how good those operators are. They're going to be, like, must pick.
There's a lot of rainbows in the game now, dude.
With the meta slowly changing, the community's interest in the game
R.I.P.
was
Kickstar, man.
And this was clear by the rise in views
R.I.P.
and
brother.
Content across all platforms.
I think Tarkov is down right now, boys. Servers are down. The same will ruin Valorant.
Cover.
I mean, the same will ruin Apex, right? Overcomplicating your game is not a good thing. It creates a lot of metas and crutch playstyles.
Dust Line was the content creation community, with many up-and-coming names such as Matimio, Bull Genius, and many, many more. This content encouraged thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, to start playing Siege.
In the last couple of days, we finally launched our Battle.ai.
Nice, Salty, it's your last day in the company.
And we're super stoked to do that because we know
today
has been asking for it.
Congrats,
right,
man.
We feel pretty good about it.
I used to love like the dark tactical theme of the game. It used to be like a very dark, serious game like Tarkov. Yeah. No, I think it was the operator's waffle. I also think removing nighttime maps and immersion was stupid. I love nighttime maps. Red Crow. The year that many consider the golden era. I would consider it the golden era. I would. I don't think I make this video, do I? Even though, mate, I was better than the bull genius, mate. He can do one. This guy's misogynistic as fuck. I resisted this whole craze because of H1, DayZ, and PUBG. I loved H1Z1, man. I loved H1Z1, dude. Overcomplicated game is bad, says Tarky Streamer.
Heading into the second year of Siege's lifespan, there were many issues that started to erupt.
Alright, hear me out, but Tarky is not a competitive shooter, right? With a team, right? Tom, I heard you had a PP reduction surgery yesterday. I hope it went well. Yeah, mate, do you want my extra meat? I'm selling it in jars, little snippets of meat.
Price. From broken shot registration to invisibility glitches. Siege had a lot of things to work on.
Bro, H1 was so good, Edda.
With a game as complex as Siege, with many systems for sound, destruction, player models and more, there were always bound to be bugs in the game. But regardless of this, a lot of these bugs made the game completely impossible to play, with the most common among these issues being hit registration and server-side issues.
Again, honestly, I disagree with that. I don't think Siege ever had many server-side issues, dude. Like, yeah, maybe once or twice. Like, again, I don't think that's true. I actually think it probably had some of the best hit reg, and you might not agree, but like, I genuinely think people did not appreciate actually how solid it was most of the time. Most of the time, it ran perfectly fine. People just like complaining. Do you know what it is? People like to whiff shots and then come up with an excuse. That's what it really is. That's what it really is. Excuses.
With pressure mounting on Ubisoft to fix all of these commonplace issues, in June 2017, Ubisoft delayed the new season.
Oh, I hated the rubber banding.
Instead, dedicates 3 months to fixing
the rubber banding.
Entirely.
Sucked. There's a sub discount for piece
of
PP.
Operation Health.
Yes. You can get 2-for-1 as a sub. Double the PP.
Using the pillar
double
system,
penetration.
The developer team at the time made a pledge to the community to fix as many of the issues as they could.
Darkie is not for
therefore
casuals.
Therefore, increasing Siege's lifespan.
I disagree. I think Tarkov's for everyone.
The number of people that we're having and players we're having every day.
It's just a very hardcore game.
That touches upon subject like matchmaking, connectivity. All those aspects are absolutely.
But casuals are the majority.
To the experience of the player. So putting that investment.
By the way, sorry to keep pausing the video, but who the fuck is to say what a casual gamer even is? Aren't we all technically kind of casual gamers? Don't we all just play games for fun, right? Unless you're a pro with a contract. Like, who's to say, let's just take Tarkov, for example. Who's to say these labs gamers that run Meta Gear every fucking day, who's to say they're not also casual gamers? Right? They're not playing in a tournament. They don't have a team. They don't practice every day under a contract.
Now on health is ensuring that in the long term, we're having a better and smoother experience for the players.
Although it was widely memed and a lot of the new
exactly,
gen players
Mudlangi.
Assumed that it didn't help,
exactly,
Operation
dude.
Health was actually a massive success, bringing way more stability to game servers,
tackling
the top reported issues at the time, and introducing new content such as alpha
it was
packs,
surprisingly not a bad time to
and
play
even introducing an elite.
How is that not a headshot?
One of the
Skips
most game-changing things that came with health.
I definitely hit him in the head. Did you not see the blood splatter?
Was the hitbox rework, which finally removed clothing and helmets from the hit registration area on a player model. Although this didn't completely get rid of the issue, it made it infinitely better than how it was before and got a lot of positive feedback from the community.
Henrik! What the fuck is- I'm recording that. I am recording.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I got a headshot! Bro, come on, man! Chill out, bro!
How many times do I have to shoot him in the face?
I love the ego that would come out of some people, man, playing this game. It's unbelievable. The things I heard playing this game, chat, was... If my mother heard some of these sentences... Oh! Where was the parents? Yeah, I agree, Phantom. I think the original devs moved on, didn't they? They moved on to another project. It lost its original identity.
Siege had ever seen, releasing a new map, tons of cosmetics, a hefty patch list, and three of the most unique operators the community had ever seen. Little did Ubisoft know that one of these would change the game forever.
Ella. It's gotta be Ella, right? Tyler 1 played Rainbow? What?
He's coming.
Yo, he's nuts! There it is! Ella. Ella Bolo.
Ella's release allowed the community to showcase the power of her scorpion.
You are not a casual, Tom. I am. Casual gamers do not play for long. They get in and out.
I think it was pretty safe to say.
Yeah, I can understand that.
Release was overpowered.
I can understand that. Bro, isn't it funny how, like, it's kind of satisfying to watch this old school version of it? Like, something about the way it looks right now and plays, it's nowhere near as satisfying to watch as it was back then. I don't know what it is.
It perished.
It's so satisfying to watch. Yeah, they slowed it down a lot, yeah. Ubi paid him and a few other large cap streamers to play with the launch of each season for a while. Tim the Tapman and a few others made like 10k plus just to play the game. Bro, they spent so fucking
Upon
much
its
on
release,
marketing.
White
it's
Noise was already changing the Intel meta, introducing operators such as Dokkaebi and Vigil, who solely relied on denying Intel.
Which by the way, they still do that, don't they? Like, they pay Shroud, Summit. They all have sponsored stream at the top of their title. They play like half a day and they get bored and get the fuck off of it.
During this time, the game also saw an increase of 27,000 more average players.
They still do that, Ubi.
At this point in time, Siege had a very diverse and unique
Ash
movement
ACOG.
System. Which allowed players to improve their gameplay and widen the skill gap.
Alright, chat, where's all my clips? Where are my clips?
Apart from a complete overhaul
Talkie
of
back,
pistol
yeah?
recoil, a mute elite, and a few bug fixes for deployable shield
Thank
collision,
you, chat.
That's pretty much all that came of White Noise. It was right
51
here.
51 rounds
where
and the rate
all
of fire of A10 Warthog, yeah. Oh, Chimera, this is where it went to shit. Lol, Waffle. Mate, Loki, yeah. I was better than half Chimera these fucking players the before they even touched the game.
I Ubisoft could have
I was winning ranked games and these kids were still wearing nappies.
Skill-based FPS game.
Motherfuckers.
I mean, this operator literally gave every single player on a team legal wall hacks and went against every single core value of the game. This clip from Bolo shows us just how broken his loadout and gadget was when it was used correctly.
Yeah, this was stupid. This was so stupid.
Oh my god. What's that? Get back. Oh my god, Bolo. What the fuck?
Oh my god!
With the release of Lion and Finker, also came the start of the worst meta Siege had ever seen. Combine these new operators with the upgraded Blitz, a Jackal and a Ying, you have the most no-skill lineup you could use to absolutely pummel an enemy team.
Cut off. He's also getting Lion, also getting Ying, detected by the E1D, Neo cleans him up.
Dude, impasse is BC, will get BC4 easily. Ryan alive, NBK, testing his control key.
A lot of people have very strong opinions on Lion, think that he's completely overpowered, that his gadget is way too strong, and that overall he's just not going to be good for the game.
And it wasn't just the casual community that was critical of Lion, even pro players were questioning him being in the game. However, all of this turmoil eventually led to Lion being banned from all tournaments in November of 2018.
Yes, Justin, Lion is an operator that...
Which, by the way... I met Justin and I met Epi? Epi was a cool motherfucker. This guy, Justin, he had a bit of... Judge, did you hear about this controversy that came out? Who was it with? It was with, a British streamer accused this guy of, like, sexual assault and, like, bullying and harassment. I feel like that also affected the whole scene as well. I don't know the full drama, but some crazy shit came out about this.
We faced a unique problem with. We know that he is overpowered, and today the dev team is ready to act on it. Starting next season, we will put Lion in a competitive quarantine, which means that the players will not be able to pick Lion in our esports programs.
Before Parabellum, legal wall hacks were running the game into the ground.
Yeah, Tarky's down, yeah. Wait, I think it's back up now, I don't know. By the way, Parabellum, I actually really enjoyed this one too.
But during Parabellum, illegal wall hacks started to overrun the rank scene, with cheats becoming more and more advanced and foreshadowing what was to become of Siege.
The cheater epidemic.
Only did cheaters begin to ruin the game, but Ubisoft made huge changes to both the look and feel of the game.
Wait, moving whose changes voice is
made
this?
The game much more choppy, and a brand new HUD was introduced.
Wait, whose voice is that?
It's just like...
They're planning to put 100 operators in the game, yeah.
Dude, they just like chopped my legs off.
Siege is becoming like
arguably,
a game of chess.
This change was actually positive because of previous controversies with quick leaning. A lot of people thought that this was a more balanced system for leaning due to Siege's netcode. On the other hand, many long-term, high-level Siege players believe that this lowered the skill ceiling and allowed less mechanically skilled to compete with the top 1%.
Can't even find their Twitter accounts?
15 months,
really?
More movement changes have been forced on the community.
That is sus, Judge.
Slowing down aiming
that is really
and making
sus.
The game feel even more clunky. This gameplay, mixed with a fast-paced utility meta that plagued the game
good luck in your raid, Inject.
Was a recipe for disaster. With little to no skill ceiling left between players, Siege was destined to collapse under its own poor decisions.
Do you remember how, like, the beginning operators had, like, their own videos with their gadgets? Like, you had Sledge with the little Sledge video where he'd come in and, like, smash the wall. Ash was in, like, this arena where, like, she was, like, testing a launcher. Like, they never even made new videos for their new operators. Like, it was so... It felt so gimmicky, like... By the way, all these tweets, cheaters already run your game, wake up. These were tweets that were like, They were like 5 years ago. 4 or 5 years ago now. Hey, Kate. What's up, you? Hope you're doing good, Kay. Much love.
Ubisoft was always considered unreliable for transparency and communication, but never before had it been this bad. Instead of putting money and resources into the issues at hand, they moved their crosshairs onto other
projects. You're an OG. You're an OG, Judge. Of course, man. Do you guys remember Hyperflop?
I thought it was going to be better. How does that happen every time?
Pros are really upset that he's just transitioning.
Do you remember Hyperflop?
Gunfight game. I think it was like pretty true. Like,
well, yeah, they're trying to make it so that you can't, you have to work together and win off of.
Where K Rection by Thump?
Utility rather than your skill and aim.
K's cooking reaction coming soon.
Within the management of Siege.
Thanks for the bits. I know you miss K. I do too.
Ubisoft did not take enough steps to acknowledge, alleviate, or resolve the ongoing crisis.
By the way, if you're just joining, we're watching the downfall of R6. Tired as fuck, me too, Kate. I've been a bit sick the past couple days, so I'm sorry if my voice is a bit off. I hope you're still entertained. But, Yo, Macha, I hope you had a good weekend, man.
It wasn't until late 2021 that the developers started taking initiative and being more open with the community, releasing consistent ban data and other updates.
No, never. I literally play 800 games in Burn Horizon. I don't think I've ever played a cheating. Like one aim button, maybe. That's it. The first time I probably noticed that there were consistent cheaters was probably like 2 years ago in Steel Wave or something.
Who were they asking?
Oh, is it shit? I literally can't play the game no more. Because every single game, it's like 4 spin bothers. Or like 7 closets. And you just literally can't play. It's cheaters every game. Oh, yeah, I thought they were pretty good. Because I thought they were going to ban a lot of cheaters. But eventually, you know, turns out to be fucking shit and they banned me and stuff. But the change, they should change a lot, but they should just start by...
I don't know this guy.
...being less incompetent, that would be really nice. Because they make some really, really, really dumb changes. You know, apparently, yeah, when people get, like, manual ban and stuff, you don't get ELO back. So I lost, like, 400 ELO to, like, Oli and stuff, and they got banned. And I go, shit, oh!
So
that was a weird take. I don't know about that.
Blast through time, and we've ended up here.
Rainbow I don't know about
Six
that take.
Is an irreplaceable
hot steamy take
FPS
right there. Hot steamy take.
With the most competitive community in the gaming world, but unfortunately, it's a goldmine of opportunity.
Standard gamer take.
Yeah.
It's cheaters. Changes
with a
are stupid. Dumb.
Base,
okay.
A quickly declining player count. Siege's future is very uncertain. With more and more players suffering from
trust me when I can tell you that there was cheaters from the get-go.
There can never be a better time for Ubisoft to look at their hard work, answer the community's call to action, and save Siege. The game we all once loved is being
held hostage
by incompetent developers, poor choices,
the copium is off the charts,
dude. And more. Ubisoft, we, the player base, implore you to reevaluate the state of the game. Restore it to its previous stature. We all know there will never be another game like Siege.
Is this coming from... Hold on. I should have looked at this first. Is this coming from like a... Okay. Okay, so this is coming from a very like biased kind of point of view. If that makes sense. Obviously, this kid's played a lot of Rainbow. He's very invested into the game. You know, like, he's made content for a couple years now. So...
And there is
bit
no
of a bias.
Other community like this one. We will not stand by and spectate the decline of this game. This has been the downfall of Siege.
Bro, puff more
Thank
copium.
Thank you all so much for watching.
Puff more copium, dude. I want whatever copium this kid's puffing, man. To be honest. to be honest. Looks like they rolled the servers back, yeah? Cheaters are a symptom, not the cause.